जय इंडिया चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम यू ऑल इन टुडेज लाइव मैथ क्लास। सो चिल्ड्रेन, आई होप यू हैव डन योर होमवर्क, राइट? सो लेट अस गेट रेडी फॉर द क्लास नाउ। सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू गेट रेडी विथ योर पेन एंड नोटबुक, राइट? सो दैट यू कुड नोट डाउन द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स। सो चिल्ड्रेन, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ इंटीजर्स एंड different properties of subtraction of integers. Am I right, children? So today we will discuss about the next operation, that is multiplication of integers and properties of multiplication of integers, right? So before that, I want to discuss a few points with you. Children, in the last class I had told you how one sign is imposed over another sign when we use two signs together at the same time. Am I right, children? So today also we will have to see if what happens when we multiply two integers, right? So if we are multiplying two integers, one positive, one negative, or one negative, one positive, or both positive, or both negative, then what is the sign of product? How do we find out what sign should be used there with the product of two integers, right? So let us see. For this, write the heading, children: sign conversion. Okay, so before we discuss about the properties of multiplication of integer, we should know about the conversion of sign when we are multiplying two integers, right? So what happens when we multiply one positive integer with another positive integer? Okay, then positive into positive equal to positive, right? So we impose positive sign over another positive sign, right? So plus and plus will always be plus. This is very simple, children. Now what happens if we multiply two negative integers? If both the integers are negative, then negative integer into negative integer, then which sign do we get, children? Minus and minus becomes plus, right, children? Negative of negative is equal to positive. Okay, children? So negative of negative becomes positive. Third rule is what happens when we are multiplying two integers with opposite sign, right? First integer is positive, second is negative, or first is negative and second is positive. Then what sign do we use with the product of integers, right? So let us see. Plus into minus. Plus into minus or minus into plus. If signs are different, then the product is negative. Right, children? This is rule. So plus into minus equal to minus and minus into plus equal to minus only. So if we are multiplying two integers with different sign, then result will be negative. If we are multiplying two integers with same sign, both are positive or both are negative, then the product will be positive. Okay? So here, friend of my enemy will be my enemy. Okay? Am I right? So we say that dushman ka dost dushman. Right? So it is just to learn, children. Okay? Don't take it seriously. So here, so enemy of my friend will be my enemy. Okay, this is a way to learn these things. So negative of positive will be negative and positive of negative things will be negative only, right? Now this is the way how we impose the sign. For example, if we write plus 3 and there is another sign outside with plus 3, okay, negative of plus 3, so minus and plus will become minus. So we will write minus 3, right? If there is negative of minus 3, minus minus 3, then minus minus will become plus. Two signs are there, they will be imposed, it will become plus, right? Take another example, plus 3 into minus 4, right? So we will multiply. Here there are two integers with opposite sign, so what do we get today? 3 4 are 12, and plus and minus will become minus, so product will be negative. So if we are multiplying two integers, two negative integers, we can say minus 5 into minus 6. So what will we get, children? Minus and minus will become plus, right? So we will write plus 5 6 are 30. So this is the way to multiply two integers, right? So let us move to the point today. Now we have to discuss about different properties of multiplication of integers, right? So write down the heading, properties of multiplication of integers. So note down, children, these properties are very important and you all are expected to learn these properties, right? So properties of multiplication. Right, children? Properties of multiplication. So first property of multiplication of integers is closure property, right? We have discussed about closure property of addition of integers. So in multiplication we will discuss about first property, that is closure property for multiplication of integers. So what is closure property of multiplication of integers? Closure property. So what is closure property? In addition, the closure property was that sum of two integers is integer. Integer plus integer is equal to integer. This was closure property of addition of two integers, right? So in the same way here, in case of multiplication, we say that if we are multiplying two integers, okay, in addition we were adding, in multiplication we will multiply, right? So if we are multiplying two integers, first integer into second integer, then their product will also be integer only, no fraction, no decimal, okay? So property of product of two integers will be same as the property of integers, right? So write down, children, product of two integers is also an integer, right, children? So we say that integer into integer equal to integer. Integer multiplied with integer equal to integer. Right, children? So here I think this part is not visible to you, so I am dictating, you can listen it, okay? Integer into integer equal to integer, right? Let us take some examples, children. For example, plus 3 is an integer, right? Multiply this with minus 4. Minus 4 is also an integer, right? Now what is the product? Plus 3 into minus 4, plus and minus becomes minus. 3 4 is 12, we get minus 12, right? So here plus 3 was integer, and this integer is multiplied with minus 4, which is also an integer, and their product minus 12 is also an integer, right? So product of two integers is integer only. So this is closure property of multiplication of integers. Clear? So let us move to the second property, that is commutative law. Okay, we have discussed about commutative law of addition of integers. What was commutative law, children? Do you remember? Let me remind you. Commutative law of addition of integer was that a plus b equal to b plus a, right? So this law allows us to change the order of two integers which are being added or being multiplied. Okay, so in mathematical operations, commutative law allows us to change the order of integers which are being operated. This operation may be addition also, may be multiplication also. Okay, this law is not true for subtraction or division. This is true only for addition and multiplication. So what is commutative law, children? Let us write it. So write down the second heading, second property, that is commutative law. So second one, commutative. So children, all of you have to learn these properties. Okay, commutative law. Right? So for any two integers, according to this law, for any two integers a and b, what can we write, children? We can write a into b equal to b into a. If we are multiplying two integers, then we can multiply them in any order. First integer into second integer, or second integer into first integer. In both the case, result will be the same, right? So 3 into 5 equal to 15. 5 into 3 is also equal to 15. Am I right, children? Let us take one example here. If we have to multiply minus 3 into minus 4, okay, and then multiply minus 4 into minus 3. In both the case, children, see here, minus 3 into minus 4, minus minus becomes plus, okay, and 3 fours are 12, right? So in multiplication, minus minus becomes plus. Don't get confused, children. In addition, when we have two negative integers, okay, and they are to be added, then sum of negative integer is negative, right? But in case of multiplication, product of two negative integers is positive. So in multiplication, minus into minus equal to plus, but in addition, minus added with minus, negative integer added with negative integer equal to negative integer. Of course we add there, but sign is negative, right? So now multiply the second part. Minus 3 into minus 4 was plus 12. Now if we have changed the order, minus 4 into minus 3, then minus minus will become plus, and 4 is a 12. So again we get the same result, today. Am I right? So we can say that minus 3 into minus 4 is equal to minus 4 into minus 3. Right? So this was commutative law. So this law allows us to change the order of integers which are multiplied together. Right? So let us move to the next law now. Next law of multiplication of integers is associative law. Right? So write down associative law of multiplication of integers. So third law of multiplication is associative law. A associative verb. Right? So for this verb, we need three integers. Okay, at least three integers must be there. So the meaning of association means group. So this law, associative law, allows us to change the group of integers which are being multiplied. If we have three or four multiples, okay, at least three integers are required. So suppose we are having three multiples, three integers which are to be multiplied, right? Then we can choose any two integers at first for multiplication, right? So we can multiply first and second integer. We can make a group of first and second integer, multiply them, find their product, and then multiply this product with the third integer, right? This is one way to multiply. Second way to multiply is that firstly multiply the second and third integer, okay? Find their product and then multiply this product with the first integer. So we can change the group. Firstly make the group of first and second integer, or firstly make the group of second and third integer. Any two numbers can be chosen at first for multiplication. Okay. In each and every case, you will see that result is always the same. Right? So what is this law, children? Let us write it. For any three integers A, B, and C. For any three integers A, B, and this one is C. Right, children? So we can write A into B into C or equal to A into B into C. A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. So here we can see we have made a group of first and second integer. Here we have made a group of second and third integer. In this case, we have multiplied first and second integer at first. We have found their product, and then we will multiply this product with the third integer C. So integer C is multiplied at last. Third integer is multiplied at last. Okay. But in second case, we have multiplied second and third integer at first. We have found their product, and at last we have multiplied the first integer. Right? So in both the case, result will be the same. So this is the law, children. Let us take some example. So I am loving this. As per this law, A into B into C is always equal to A into B into C. Right, children? For example, suppose A equal to minus 4, B equal to minus 3, C equal to 2. These are three integers, right? Now put the value of these integers in the in this law, the left hand side part of this expression is A into B into C. So write A into B into C. Firstly find the value of A into B into C. Okay, how? Put the value of A. What is value of A, children? Minus 4. So write minus 4 into B. Value of B is minus 3. So into minus 3. Right? And A into B, they are in one single bracket. So write the product of minus 4 and minus 3 inside a square bracket, because they are already having a small bracket, right? So we will use square bracket here to combine them. And into C, what is value of C? Value of C is 2. So write 2 outside. Now solve this, children. Minus 4 into minus 3 equal to what? 12. 4 threes are 12, and minus becomes plus, right? So we get plus 12 into 2. So finally we get 24. Plus 12 into plus 2. Plus and plus equal to plus. So directly multiply 12 to the 24. Right? Now take the second part of this expression. A into B into C. Put the value of A, B and C in second part and find their result. And check if this result is equal to first one or not. Right? So write A into B into C. This was expression. Put the value of A, B and C. Value of A is how much? Value of A is minus 4. So minus 4 into B into C inside one bracket. Value of B. B is minus 3. So write here minus 3 into C. What is value of C, children? 2, right? Value of C is here 2, as you can see. So into 2. Now solve this. Minus 4 into, firstly multiply minus 3 and 2. Minus 3 is negative integer, plus 2 is positive integer. So minus and plus will become minus. Okay? So product will be minus 3 to the 6. Product will be negative. Right? Now minus 4 into minus 6. We have to multiply them. So minus and minus becomes plus. Right? So put plus sign and 4 6 the 24. So see, children, we have again got the same result. Here we have got 24. Here again the result is 24 only. So in both the case our result is the same, right? So we can say that what? Minus 4 into minus 3 into 2 will be equal to minus 4 into minus 3 into 2, right? So A into B into C will be equal to A into B into C, right, children? So this is associative law. So now let us move to the next property, that is distributive law of multiplication, children, right? So what is distributive law of multiplication? Let us see now. So let me rub it. Write down the next heading, that is distributive law of multiplication. This is fourth property, that is distributive law. Distributive law, right? So what is distributive law? If we have three integers A, B and C, then for any three integers, A, B and C, we can write A into B plus C equal to A into B plus A into C. Right, children? A into B plus C equal to A into B plus A into C. This is distributive law, children. If you are not able to see, I am writing it from here. Again, A into B plus C equal to A into B plus A into C. Right, children? So this is distributive law. If we have to multiply any integer with the sum of two integers, right? Here inside the bracket you can see that two integers b and c are added. B and c are two integers, okay, which are added. Then we can solve this expression in two different ways, right? How? Firstly, you add these integers, then multiply with the integers outside. This is the first way. Second way is that you don't add these two. Firstly, multiply the integer outside with both the integers inside the bracket, right? So while multiplying the integer outside, we will have to multiply this integer with both the integers inside the bracket. So a will be multiplied with b also, and a will be multiplied with c also, right? So we have distributed this integer. Here there is multiplication of integer a, and this multiplication of integer a is distributed over both the numbers inside the bracket, right? So here we are distributing the multiplication over the addition of these two integers. So a will be multiplied with b, that is a into b, and here plus sign is there, so put plus sign and then multiply a with c also, right? So what does it mean? Suppose in a bucket you are having some bananas and some cherries, right? So if I ask you to make the fruits in the bucket double, okay, we have to multiply two with the fruits inside the bucket, okay, then it means you have to multiply two with the number of bananas also and with number of cherries also, right? So if we have to multiply two with the number of banana and cherry, these two are there in the same bucket, okay, we are multiplying with two. So it means that we have to multiply two with both the numbers, right? So we will take two times of b also and two times of c also. So bananas, number of bananas will be doubled. At the same time, number of cherries will also be doubled. Okay. So this is very common mistake, children, that students used to make. What? Student used to multiply this number outside with the first integer only. Okay. Whenever we ask to multiply one integer with the sum of two integers, then many of the students used to multiply the number outside with the first integer only. And this is a common mistake, children. So don't make this mistake. Okay. We have to multiply the number outside with both the integers inside the bracket. So we have to distribute the number outside with both the integers inside the bracket. Right? So let us see this with some example, if it is true or not. So what was distributed after then? It was a into b plus c is equal to what? A into b plus a into c, right? Let us take some value of a, b and c. Suppose value of a is minus 3, value of b is 2, and value of c is minus 1, right? Now firstly find the value of a into b plus c. How? A into b plus c. Put the value of a, this is minus 3, in place of a write minus 3. So firstly write minus 3 for a, then into, minus 3 into b plus c. So I am writing it here, minus 3 into b plus c. Value of b is 2, right? And plus value of c is minus 1. a a into b plus c will be equal to a. In place of a, write minus 3 into, in place of b, you have to write 2 plus, in place of c, you have to write value of c, that is minus 1. So we get this. Now solve this, children. So minus 3 into 2 plus minus 1. There are two integers with opposite sign. We will subtract, right? So 2 minus 1 equal to 1. And 2 is greater than 1, so we will use plus sign, right? So minus 3 into 1 will give minus 3. Right, children? So this is minus 3. Their product is minus 3. Now solve the second part, a into b plus a into c, right? So what is the value of a into b plus a into c? Put the values. Value of a is minus 3 into b. Value of b is 2. So we will write here, in place of a into b, we will write minus 3 into 2, right? So write minus 3 into 2. A into b equal to minus 3 into 2 plus a into c now. So plus a, value of a is minus 3. So write minus 3 into c. Value of c is minus 1. Minus 1. If it is not visible, children, then listen to me carefully and try to solve it. Right? So, find the value of this now. Minus 3 into 2. Minus 3 is negative integer. 2 is positive integer. So, their product will be negative because they are having opposite sign. Right? So, minus 3 into 2. 3 to just 6. And sign will be minus. Am I right? Plus. Now minus 3 into minus 1 there. Children, so minus and minus becomes plus. Right? And 3 1 ja 3. So we will write plus 3. Now minus 6 plus 3. Minus 6 is negative integer. It is added with positive integer plus 3. So, they are having opposite sign. So, we will subtract, right? To subtract, 6 minus 3 equal to 3. And which sign we will use, children? Because 6 is greater, so we will use sign of 6, that is minus sign. So, put minus sign here. Right, children? Now, see the result. Here, value of a into b plus a into c is minus 3. And value of a into b plus c, this is also equal to minus 3, right? So in both the case, we get the same result. So we can say that a into b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. So multiplication of an integer with sum of two integers is made by multiplying the integer outside with both the integers inside the bracket. And after that, we will add the product. So here we have added, then multiplied. Here, firstly, we will find the product and then we will add the product. Okay? So, this was your distributive law, children. So, now, children, let us move to the next property of integer. Okay? Multiplication of integer. So, let us see what is the next property. So, property number 5. For any integer a, write down, children, for any integer a, what do we have? A into 1. If we multiply any integer with 1, or we multiply 1 with any of the integer, then same integer a is reflected on the other side. Right, children? Plus 5 into 1 equal to plus 5. Minus 6 into 1 equal to minus 6. Okay, same integer is reflected on other side. It means if any of the integer is standing before 1, then the same integer is reflected on the other side. So one is just like mirror. If we stand before mirror, then our image is reflected on other side. So mirror shows our identity. Am I right, children? So this integer 1, when multiplied with any integer, okay, reflects the other integer on the other hand, other side. So this 1 is known as identity. Okay. And which identity, children? This is multiplicative identity. Right? So because 1 is, 1 works as identity in case of multiplication. So we say that 1 is multiplicative identity. In case of addition, do you know which number is used as additive identity? Children, in case of addition, 0 is additive identity. Am I right? Because any integer added with 0 equal to same integer on other side. So 0 is additive identity, right? But in case of multiplication, 1 is multiplicative identity. Integer, any integer multiplied with 1 equal to same integer on other side, right? So this is case of multiplicative identity. So you can write it here. 1 is known as multiplicative identity. Right, children? Plus 6 into 1 equal to plus 6. It is so easy, children. So this was your fifth property, right? So now let us move to the next property. What is the next property, children? So property number 6. So according to this property, children, for any integer a, we can write a into 0 equal to 0 into a is equal to 0. It's so simple, children. If we multiply any integer with 0, or we multiply 0 with any of the integer, then result is always 0, right? So this is the sixth property. Plus 5 into 0 equal to 0. Plus 100 equal to 0 equal to 0. So no matter how large the number is, if we are multiplying that number with 0, then result will always be equal to 0, right? So this was all about properties of multiplication of integers, children. You all are supposed to note down these properties in your fair notebook and learn these properties today only. Right, children? So I hope you have understood. Make practice on this and learn all the properties. So children, with this, we finish this class today. So thank you and Jai Hind.